anybody who provokes imagination is only pushing you further into the mental quagmire. Spirituality is about a calming down of imagination. It is about a silence. It is not about more theories, more fancy dreams, more beautiful visions. Spirituality is not a well dressed up adult. Spirituality is a naked child. Yes, you can read them for fun. No, see, there is no obligation to be talking in spiritual terms at all times. I only have an issue with those who present things of the mind as spiritual. If someone wants to write something that he dreamt of, some fiction, he is most welcome. But if he says, no, this is spiritual fiction, then I have an issue with that. And there is a lot of spiritual fiction being sold these days. Just too much of it.
Thinking this poet Grace is quoting here, "All your answers are so near." And I was reading one of the Krishnamurti books, and I think my question was, if we keep on seeking and reading books, does that take us away from the stillness?
Don't read books for the sake of seeking. Read books because books are wonderful. Do not go to books to search for an answer. Go to books just as one goes to a friend. One doesn't go to a friend to search for something. One goes to a friend because the company of the friend is a peaceful company. Do not search for anything in books. You will only get what you bring to the books. If you go to a book searching for something, you will only get what you have brought to the book. The book will not offer you anything new.
I still come to Paulo Coelho books. And I still enjoy books like that.
As long as you know that this is just entertainment, entertain yourself. No, nothing wrong with that. There are so many nonsensical movies one watches precisely because they are nonsensical. In fact, the more nonsensical they are, the more is their attraction. But if one says, no, this is about truth, then there is a...
I found when reading out of fun in that way, things unfold naturally as opposed to seeking and trying to draw something from it. I, for for example, when I first read The Prophet by Khalil Gibran, it was such a delight to read. I just read it over and over, and as I kept reading, it was just blossoming. It was not reading it to try and study it and go, okay, this is how I'm going to behave now, and this is how the answer should come in this situation. It wasn't like that. It was smelling a rose in a sense.
Yes. You know, that is why the ones who are most likely to misinterpret a book, a religious book, the ones who are most likely to misinterpret a religious book are the followers of that religion. Because they are the ones most likely to go to that book searching for the truth. And when you are searching for the truth, it is impossible that you will find it. When you are not looking for it, then it is all yours. When you are looking for it, then just the looking for is yours.
This teacher once said about this, he said, the Bible said the kingdom of heaven is in you, in that sense, that the truth. So why do you still search in the Bible for the truth?
But that does not mean that the Bible is worthless. The Bible, just as in the world, there are n things that you can company with, that you can live with, spend your time with. Why not spend time with at least parts of the Bible? I mean, you are alive, right? And you are spending your time somewhere. Why not spend your time with a Krishna rather than with some miscellaneous fellow? There is something called good company, or is it not?